I'm Jennifer Smart, and we are here at the 2010 Consumer Electronics Show in Las Vegas, where vendors show off products you'll see in stores later this year. I'm Jennifer Smart, and I'm speaking with Brian Cooley, CNET Editor-at-Large. What does an Editor-at-Large do?
You know, Jennifer, I do so many things that they call me Editor-at-Large. That means that I cover a lot of different kinds of technology, from TVs to digital cameras, MP3 players, pretty much anything. But I do go real deep on cars. That's kind of my specialty. So the car beat is my, you know, my real deep area. But I know a little bit about a lot of technology.
You've been reporting on technology for a long time. What did you do before that?
Before I came to CNET, I was a radio announcer and a newsman in the morning. So I did a lot of morning radio shows from about 1983 until 1995 when I came to CNET. And then I came to CNET when it was very early days for the internet. So it was kind of a small, odd little company, and I had to explain to people what I did. It's like, you work for a what? Well, a website. It's this thing you get on your computer. So it was really kind of a little sketchy in the early days, but I had a feeling we were going to do okay.
How many CESs have you been to?
You know, I was just thinking about that the other day. Somebody asked me that. I want to say I've been to 7. So that's a pretty good number, but I know folks who've been to like 20 or more. So I feel like a kid sometimes.
What changes have you seen over the years as far as CES is concerned?
Well, you know, some years we have one single product or device that is totally dominating the show. Other years we have a mix. This is one of those years where we have a mix. There's no one thing that is the blowout headline. Last year we had the Palm Pre smartphone that kind of dominated all the talk around the show. So that's one thing that differs year to year. And this year is definitely a little quieter. There are fewer people exhibiting and fewer people who are here because, you know, the economy and people's budgets and all that. But I kind of like it because there's a little more room to breathe. You can get to who you want to get to and learn about the products that are on the floor without having to fight these crowds all the time. And I also find that I'm waiting a lot less long in the lines for taxi cabs, and that's great.
What have you seen so far this year that you're most excited about?
Well, here's what I'm excited about, but not positively excited, kind of negatively excited, and that is 3D TV, which I kind of scratch my head on that one. I get the impact of 3D. I've tried these sets. They're great. They're amazing, the depth of field effect you get. But at the same time, I don't see myself putting on goggles to watch TV at home, which you have to do still with this technology. And I have a feeling that consumers have just recently bought their HD TVs in the last 1, 2, or 3 years and aren't ready to go buy another expensive TV. I'm not. So I think a lot of people are going to feel like me. It's like, okay, it's really expensive to go upgrade my TV or TVs, and there's a bunch of gadgets that I have to put on to watch these, and there's not a lot to watch yet. There's going to be a long period of years while we build up a lot of content that's available in 3D. So those things, they give me some concerns.
Do you have a dream technology gadget that hasn't been out yet?
You know, my dream for technology is to have everything in the car internet connected wirelessly. So you'd have streaming radio, you'd have voice over IP like Skype calling in the dashboard, you know, for passengers to use the video or for the driver to use for audio. You'd have navigation done over the internet just like you use Google Maps on your smartphone. To me, everything in the car should be done over the internet wirelessly, because that way everything is fresh and new and I can get more media choices, I can get maps that are up to date, I can get lookups on Yelp and things if I'm looking for a restaurant or a hardware store or whatever. That would be really cool to me. We kind of got halfway there at this show. Ford has rolled out Pandora you can use on your car. It'll be coming out later this year. A few early apps, but I'm waiting for that to blow out so it's on every car and even on car stereos that you could buy, or car computers, I guess we'd call them then, that you could buy and put in any car you already own.
How is the integration with CBS making CNET even better?
Well, you know, CBS is such a big television company and a big radio company, and CNET doesn't do that. CNET is obviously an online interactive company, so that kind of gives us a whole lot of additional avenues for people to find out what we do. So we appear a lot on CBS news programs, like my colleague Natalie Del Conte is on the CBS Early Show a lot, and a whole variety of us editors like myself and Brian Tong and Molly Wood and Tom Merritt, we get access to more CBS television and radio appearances, and that's great because at the end of the day we want people to know what CNET does. And you can never tell that story too much because we're doing new stuff all the time. Also, it's great to have a really big media company that you're part of, an integral piece of, because you end up being part of the ebb and the flow of this very very chaotic time in media, and you're right at the center of it. So as everybody from content producers to advertisers to technology makers are trying to figure out, wait a minute, which way is media going, CBS is one of the very first companies they think of to be in touch with and work with. So we're even more in the middle of what's going on with media.
I understand there's a charity that you're really passionate about. Can you tell us about it?
There is. In fact, you know, here we are talking tech, you know, but I think you and I are both totally in love with animals, right? Okay. So there are several, actually, but one that I work with a lot is Best Friends Animal Sanctuary in Utah. It's in Kanab, Utah, a little town in the very southern end of Utah, kind of in the middle of Utah and Arizona, and not far from here in Las Vegas. In fact, I often drive out there after this show. It's about a three-hour drive. And it's just the most amazing place where dogs, cats, reptiles, birds, and horses, and whoever needs rescuing, are taken care of in a state-of-the-art way like you'll never see anywhere else. And it was founded by about a dozen really caring animal lovers back in the 1970s, and they had nothing. They came in there, they had to build this place in a canyon all by themselves. They bought the land, and they built up what I think is the greatest animal shelter I've ever encountered in the United States. And more importantly than being a shelter themselves, they get the word out and they reach out all over the country. They do rescues whenever there's a major animal emergency anywhere in the country. They were really big on helping out getting animals out of Katrina, out of New Orleans when the storm hit. And I go down there and I volunteer. I try to go down at least once a year and spend a day or two volunteering there and to contribute and to get the word out, like on shows like yours. And so I was so excited when you guys said, hey, I want to have you guys, I'm going to have you on to talk tech, but also about your animal charity. So that's a great thing. I'm also a big fan of a place in New Jersey that a colleague of mine at CNET launched, a guy named Jonathan Rosenberg, who was our chief technology officer at CNET in our founding days. And then after he, you know, did his thing, had his career go well, he checked out and went completely different direction. He opened a place called Tabby's Place, named for his cat Tabby, and it's a cat sanctuary in New Jersey, in between New York and Princeton, kind of in rural New Jersey, and it's also a great place, and they're at tabbysplace.org, and they focus on the cats that nobody else will take at the shelter, the hard cases, the ones that have medical issues or maybe developmental issues, they were born with some birth defects or something. That's another great shelter that I love.
You're from the Bay Area. How did you get involved with a charity in Utah?
Well, we worked with a number of organizations near us in the San Francisco area when Katrina happened, when the storm happened in New Orleans. And several of the cats that were airlifted out of there that I was involved in fostering for a few weeks to get them back on their feet then were related to other animals that went to Best Friends. And so I learned kind of through the grapevine of animal shelters about this place. And also I'd heard about a major effort they did when there were a lot of dogs that were left homeless in Beirut, Lebanon, during an outbreak of violence there. And they airlifted hundreds of dogs from over there. That's a long way to go to pick up, you know, a bunch of animals and move them across oceans. And a lot of people won't do that. So I've heard about them as much in the news as I did through other humane societies that I know that have great respect for them. So you get all these indications that it's a great organization. And that's a great way to figure out if an animal shelter is really good is, you know, do other shelters think highly of it? It's a good way to kind of check it out.
How can people get more information about Best Friends?
They go to bestfriends.org for Best Friends. They have a really good website, too. You know, some animal shelters, they do great work, but they don't have great websites. That's not what they do. But, of course, Best Friends is a long-running organization, and they get the web. So it's a good site to go to. You'll find a lot there to learn about what they're doing that's always updated. And, of course, Tabby's Place, being run by Jonathan, a former tech CTO at CNET, also a really good website. So tabbysplace.org. Those are both great, great organizations.
How can people get more information about you and CNET?
Well, you can find me at CNET.com. Just go to CNET and just type in my name if you want to find the latest stuff that I've done. If you want to just focus on my car tech stuff, go to cars.cnet.com, which is our car website. And if you just want to see videos that I've done or my other fellow editor hosts like Molly Wooden, Tom Merritt, and Brian Tong, go to CNETTV.com. So we put our video there. So there's a lot of ways to find us on CNET. It depends on whether you want to go look at our specialty or our video content or just go to our front door and just type in the name of your favorite host.
Thank you.
Jennifer, thank you for having me on your show. This is great.